kids to go class. Today I, Shivani, your science teacher, a geek here to tell you about the topic synthetic fibers and plastic. Are you excited? Let's come.
Today we're going to learn about synthetic fibers and plastics. So the first question arises in our mind that what is fiber? A fiber is a strong and flexible thread-like material which is used to make fabric. Now, let's discuss about the types of fibers. There are two types of fibers, natural fibers and synthetic fibers, or we call human-made fibers, right? Okay, so the natural fibers are those which we are getting from the plants and animals, example, cotton, wool, etc. A synthetic fiber is a chain of smaller units which are joined together. Each small unit is a chemical substance called monomer. Many such smaller units or monomer join together to form a large single unit called a polymer. Now, let's see the types of synthetic fibers. First is rayon. It is a synthetic fiber that has a silk-like appearance. It was developed as an alternate to silk fiber. Thus, it is also called artificial silk. Rayon is made from a natural occurring polymer called cellulose, which is extracted from wood pulp. Next is nylon. Nylon was first fully synthetic fiber to be made. Nylon derived its name from the first letters of New York and the first three letters of London, the two cities which is simultaneously developed and marketed. Then polyester. Polyester is a general name for a group of one of the most widely used synthetic fibers in the world. Polyesters are the long chain polymer of the compounds generally termed as esters. Then next is acrylic. Acrylic is a synthetic fiber which has properties like wool. It is natural substitute for wool. Acrylic is cheaper and more durable than wool. It is also known as acrylene. And the last one is lycra. Lycra is a long chain of synthetic polymer fiber known as spandex. It is soft and rubber-like and has the ability to stretch. It regains its original shape. Now let's discuss about the advantages and disadvantages of synthetic fibers. The advantages of the synthetic fibers are it regains its shape. It has a resistance to bacterial attack. It has a resistance to moisture. It dries quickly. It has effective cost and it is easy to maintain. Now the disadvantages of synthetic fibers. It repels moisture. It catches fire easily and it can easily stick to skin. Now, let's discuss about the plastic. A plastic is a synthetic material which on being heated becomes soft and can be molded into a desired shape and then hardened to provide a durable article. Now, the properties of plastics. It is a non-reactive. It has lightweight. It can be molded easily. It is cheap and it is bad conductors of heat and electricity. Now let's discuss the types of plastics. The first one is thermoplastic. Plastic which is easily get deformed, becomes soft on heating and can be bent easily are known as thermoplastic. Polyethylene, polyvinyl chloride and polystyrene are the examples of the thermoplastics. Now let's discuss about the thermosetting plastics. Plastics which once molded into a shape does not become soft on heating and cannot be molded again are called thermosetting plastics. Bakelite, melamine and formica are the examples of the thermosetting plastics. Now let's see the disadvantages of the plastics. It chokes drains, it prevents seepage of water in the soil and it releases harmful gases when burnt. How to reduce the use of plastic? This is very important for all of us. So let's see the points. And these are recycle it, use jute or cloth bag. It is very important to dispose plastic properly. And please use goods with less packaging instead of having more packaging. These are the few points which helps us to reduce the use of plastics. Thank you.
Hope you have enjoyed the video and learned something from that. So till then, wait for the next video. Stay happy, stay safe. Bye-bye, everyone.